So now that we know that cache blocks need to be at aligned memory addresses, let's look at what the memory and cache look like in terms of blocks. Our memory can be seen as just a huge array of memory locations. Let's say this is location number 0, and let's say that each location is 4 bytes wide, so the next location is at address 4, and then 8, and so on. Let's say that our block size is 16 bytes. That means that a possible block in memory is this. This would be the first block. This would be the second block. This would be the third block, and so on. A cache, then, can be considered to be a number of slots where a block can fit. In this case, we have just a two-block cache. So the cache size is just equal to two block sizes. So our memory has blocks of data, and our cache has lines, which are basically slots where a block can fit. So we can say, for example, that block number 0 can be fetched into the cache and placed in line number 0. So when we want to make a precise distinction between the space in the cache where we can put a block and the actual memory content we put there, the space in the cache is called a line, and the stuff we put there is called a block. The line size and the block size are the same. So a line is effectively a slot where a block might fit.